Measles. We are talking about this condition because it is among the top killer diseases. It can be severe, particularly in Africa. We are going to address the five questions as usual. We define this disease, measles. We check the causes, diagnosis, complications, treatment, and prevention. Let's see part one of this measles. What is measles and what causes measles? Then we see the sign and symptoms and how to diagnose it. Measles is a viral illness which is caused by virus in the family of paramyxovirus, genus of morbivirus. It is characterized by cough, cold rise up, malaise, high fever, and conjunctivitis. It will be followed by a maculopapular rash. We are going to see what this maculopapular rash is. The rash will be spreading from head to trunk, lower, going to the lower extremities. That's the direction. You can see this macule. The papule, macule all over, they are reddish. Call them erythematous. So they will be spreading downwards. Most measles related deaths are caused by complication that it causes. Unfortunately, it does affect mainly children under 5 years. We remember that children under 5 years, they don't have enough immunity. Soldiers of the body are not yet enough compared to adult people. If you are traveling to an area which is endemic and you are not vaccinated, you are at high risk. You need to note that. Children who are malnourished, like those who are marasmic or they have a kwashiorkor core, they will be at risk of contracting the disease, and eventually the complications will be very severe. You can see these ones, this is not getting fat, not at all. This is what you call kwashiorkor core. Okay? So pregnant mothers and the babies that they are carrying, they are at risk. Once they get infection, not vaccinated, that will be a very bad news. Countries which are underdeveloped, which in the development route, they are at high risk because the incidences and the prevalence is higher in those regions. Measles is highly contagious. That's what is known. In 2018, there were more than 140,000 measles deaths globally. Mostly what? Among children who are under 5 years. We need to note that. But during the period of 2000 to 2018, measles vaccination prevented an estimated 23.2 million deaths. This is a very good news. It's a good news that the vaccine helped a lot. We could have lost more than 23 million people, but vaccination prevented those deaths. Global measles deaths have decreased significantly, just by 73%, from estimated of 536,000 in 2000 to 142,000 in 2018. This is a good news, the report from World Health Organization. So what causes measles? Measles is caused by this virus, paramyxovirus family. It's a very cruel virus, which does cause damages. So once it infects the body, it will remain active and very contagious in the air, on the infected surfaces, for up to 2 hours until it dies. So it can be transmitted by an infected person from day 4 prior to the onset of the rash, which means if a person gets infected, before even you see the signs, or before there are symptoms, before the patient now complains, just those period of 4 days, you can still transmit the disease. That's a period you call incubation period. That's a dangerous period because you won't know anything about the condition. The transmission is known to be the most contagious disease. Probably with this corona now, corona might have taken over. We never know. It is spread by coughing, sneezing, and close personal contact, direct contact with infected what? nasal or throat secretions. From the mouth, coughing, sneezing. How do you know that one has measles? We are talking now about diagnosis. Alright, so when you check, we're talking about incubation period. From the time of infection, it will take at least 10 days until now signs will start showing off. What happens is, the time infection comes in, the virus will continue to multiply and they will reach the high peak on the day 10. In that time now, you will start seeing signs. The rash, the whole of the body, and you can see the coplic spots. We will see what this coplic spot is. Now that time, the body now will start preparing itself, fabricating antibodies, soldiers of the body. Then on the day 15, the antibodies will start increasing in number to fight the virus. But at that time now, the virus will start disappearing. However, in this period, it will already have caused the problems to many systems of the body. The coplic spots, it's one of the important sign not to miss when you are diagnosing measles. It's a spot that you find in the mouth. The other thing is the temperature, the fever, which is around 40. This is too high. It can cause a damage to the brain. There are three signs that you cannot miss with the measles, which is characterized by three C's: coughing, coryza, and conjunctivitis. Just look at these signs, then you say, no, this might be measles. Generalized maculopapular erythematous rash. Erythema, it means they are reddish rash on the body. You can see this macule, papule, all over the body. Reddish, that's how they look like. When you check the mouth now, you will see the tiny white spots with bluish center inside. This one, we call them pathognomonic sign. It means they are characteristic. You might not find it to other diseases, but here for measles, you find them in the mouth, okay? When you check now how it is getting spread, going down to other parts of the body, it does evolve in that direction. It does not spare the hands. Most of other conditions don't go to the hands, but measles does. You see the conjunctivitis? Inflammation of the conjunctiva. You can see it's very red, and very soon get infected because other bacteria might come in as well and take advantage. Measles can complicate into encephalitis. Encephalitis means inflammation of the brain tissue. Inflammation, where we have a fever, headache, the consciousness will be altered, behavior disturbance, disorientation, speech disturbances, seizures, nausea, vomiting, hemiparesis. Hemiparesis means one side of the body get paralyzed. That's a sign that the brain is suffering, that will depend on which part of the body is affected. It can be monoplasia, mono, one limb, it can be the whole body. It depends on which level it has gone. Now you can take a swab. You go to the mouth, you take on those really coplic spots, you can take a sample and you go and examine what's going on. Then serological test, you take a blood, you go and examine the serum. Other confirmation test that can be done is virological test. You can do what you call PCR, polymerase chain reaction, to go and identify which virus is it. Okay, that's for diagnosis. I'm inviting you to follow part 2, where we are going to see the complications and how to treat this condition, how to prevent it. Thank you so much. Health education, health promotion is our song. Thank you.